Hello YouTubers, Trotz here, back with more Factorio Megabase. This should be my last video before 1.0 comes out, and that means we should try to hit 1,000 science per minute in this episode. And I think we're gonna do it. Just traveling over to our science base, which is just hopefully finishing up being constructed. It's probably been about almost 2 hours since the last episode. We actually still have some cannon trains going around and clearing out the wall area. You see this one is now out of ammo, and that's at 134. So it's going to go on to 136 next, but it's not going to have any ammo to clear this out. So we'll probably have a few attacks happening. Well, like here right now, at least from those bases, and throughout the episode. But yeah, hopefully we'll make it. Here we are coming to the factory, which mostly should have just beacons left to place. So let's get this factory ready to run. We should be turning around here, yeah. And pulling into the station. Let's put the train on manual so it doesn't go anywhere without us. Oh! Ooh, that's not good. I guess I did hook this up at some point, and the fuel train came in. Unfortunately, we have a train sitting here already. Can I just mark the train for deconstruction without the tracks? Apparently not. Yeah, let's... What can I get rid of? I'm probably not going to be using much steel. And now we can put the train in here. What I don't have... You can see the trains are now being loaded up with fuel. What I don't have is the exit set up yet. So let's do that right now. Yeah, I know. Entrance segment is exactly what we want. Let's, that's gonna break some train network stuff for a moment, but that should fix it back up, including power. There we go. Where are you going? Oh, I guess down was set up first so it planned its route that way. I mean, the train's probably been sitting there for at least a half hour, but hopefully nothing else needs, like, we didn't run out of, fuel in any other locations. Generally, the fuel lasts a long time in the train, so it's not needed that often. Yeah, you can see, where's the fuel? Fuel? That can't be the fuel for this, can it? that looks like it's going to have a problem. Well, we're not using... Yes, we are. how do we... Well, I know one way of fixing that. We'll just do that, and then we'll, like... copy the fuel blueprint over here. What are you placing in? Some pipes? There should be plenty of pipes here. I think I parked my train there at one point. And it probably sucked up... Well, obviously lots of items. Alright, and now we just put this back down. It should only need to put the one chest back. Okay. Yeah, you can see there's a bunch of beacons missing. Oh, and we got some belts missing. Why aren't you placing belts? There should be plenty here. Don't stand on a track. Well, there aren't plenty here. $1,500. Where are we making the belts? Why aren't you making belts? Out of lubricant? Why are we out of lubricant? Okay, I'm not sure what changed, but we're now. Making solid fuel out of the petroleum gas, which should allow light oil to be cracked into petroleum gas, which should allow heavy oil to be produced. Backed up on light oil. Where's our cracking? Can't see. This is hooked up. This should be like, hey, if there's 20,000 light oil or something. I'll have to revisit that. We are slowly making lubricant and belts. I think it's just because of the mix of things. Like, we need a lot more belts than we need. Like, if we were also making circuits for using a plastic, then we wouldn't have this issue right now. Well, the train will be over here in a short bit. I think it leaves with 2,000 belts, which, I mean, should be plenty. Let's just tell it to come. All right. We need to set these trains up. It looks like they're all fueled now. So let's do that. And while I'm doing that, I can show you what we've done in terms of factories. Yeah, lots of missing beacons there. So here's our iron outpost. There's a control. Well, it's shift. And we want full cargo before we leave. Where did... Oh. Oh, that's not good. That is kind of very not good. Okay, yeah, I forgot to rename the other stations. The stations of the last last science factory, and now if I try to rename them or this, they'll all get mixed up. So I think the easiest way to deal with that is just get rid of those. And let's get rid of these. So now there's only one set of stations. Science zero. So when I rename the station, these four trains that are already here will be set to it. So you should be, you know, this should be three. And you should be three. See, if I rename this to 3 while there was already another 0, all these trains would go, oh, there's still a 0, I should go over to that one. And I wouldn't want that. Yes, I know I'm out of inventory. So these are all 3 now. Fantastic. I can now take the blueprint for the science factory. Ooh, ooh, come on. Solar factory, kickstart outpost. Here we go, and rotate. And now if I place it back down, all the trains and the tracks should all be put back, and now they'll be still zero here, but there'll be no other zero. Oh, that's what the problem is. I got a bunch of fuel. And they're all non-stackable. Ooh, what happened? Why do we have all these? Oh. Hey, yeah, you're the iron guy. You go there. And you'll be out of the way. Let's get my 50 motors back. I did also add something special to this train. Alright, we got our belts going in. How many, beacons? It's 180, 200, 300, a little over 300, so maybe that's 2 trips, because 2 more trips, let's call that. How many? You got 1,200 belts. We probably shouldn't have that many belts left to place. It looks like just a couple hundred. If that at this point. So really what we need is beacons. Let's you got replaced. Where did that train go? It didn't. Okay. What do I have in my inventory that I can safely get rid of? I don't need stone at this moment. Do we have logistics spots here? No. That's why I have 50 in my inventory. And you're gonna bring me stuff, aren't you? Hopefully we may have to go and see about this factory. Meanwhile, I'm gonna build something over here real quick. Yeah, that should work. Those take really long to handcraft, especially when you're crafting all the wires. I hope I made enough. I think I need that many more. We can come back and, well, this stuff's gonna be clogging all up my inventory if I come back. Hopefully it'll just take another minute. And, you know, while that does craft, we can, you know, finish setting up the trains that I had to take apart and reset up, I guess. And then we'll go check on that factory. It's control, right? Shift. Full cargo. Remove that. Copy. Paste. You are coal, you should be iron. That was a paste, right? And you're an iron paste. All the other outposts are just south. So here's oil, which I pipe over here. This is stone. Here's nice copper. Here's the coal. And water is over here. Copy. Paste. Paste, paste. Stone, not in activity, but full cargo. Copy, paste. Coal, nice big patch of coal, full cargo, copy, paste, and paste. I think that's it for coal. Oil. Cargo, copy, paste, and paste. water, full cargo. Copy. Paste. And I think that's all the trains ready. Let's head over here and check out the Kickstarter factory. Now, while we're waiting, let's actually get these trains going. That's not what I wanted to do. Wrong key. Why are they all going that way? Okay, you're going that way. We parked here. I was watching the mini map. Alright, let's take a look at this. This seems good. Okay, you can't output anymore. It really looks like, yeah, it's the light oil that's all clogged up. Where do you go? You go to here, you go to here, you go over here, to here. Alright, that should only run if the lubricant is greater than 5,000, and it is not. So all the heavy oil should be going. To make lubricant. But because light oil is all backed up, There's solid fuel right there. Why can't you grab it? Or we're stuck on the output. So we don't have basically a place to dump excess. Do we have coal? We do have coal. It's basically just for the plastic. How am I gonna do this? maybe not from there. Doesn't really help me. I was hoping to put in a splitter. Turn it now. what if we turn it here? We can't get past there. What's attacking you? Alright, you should hold. And you should hold. Thank you. Yeah, this is interesting. Let's turn off my robots because I'm kind of full of stuff at the moment. Alright, we're getting across. Except we're not. Except we are. Okay, I think I have this figured out. Really, we don't have. We're missing stone bricks. I got rid of my stone. Alright, what? I'm not building outposts right now. Where are my... See, I wish you could hover over this and have it blink over here. No. Why don't I see... Because they're covered in numbers. There we go. Now I can pick up some stone bricks. I can craft. Now I can pick up some stone bricks. And I can craft an oil refinery. And I can tell you to be coal liquefaction. Unfortunately, that radar is going to have to go. And, you know, so is this power pole. They can just move over there. we are not doing so great. Well, this actually kind of works out better. We need some steam. Two should be plenty, I think. All right, I know we have those logistics bots. Going to request some solid fuel. And that solid fuel is going to be provided by this nice solid fuel maker from light oil, because we want to use up light oil. We need water. We have water right here. Now, the only thing we need is a little heavy oil. And obviously coal. Okay, I can now make a wire. Turn this around and say, only when there's more than 1,000, more than 1,000 oil, or 5,000 oil. Heavy oil. Let's make some more of these wires. where are we measuring? Everything is measured over here. And this should have most everything in signals. Want to enable this when light oil is less than 20,000. So this should be off right now. See, the pumping speed is 0 of 12,000. So when the light oil gets kind of full, we want to stop the normal oil production and only rely on the coal liquefaction, which outputs mostly heavy oil. Now the heavy oil will get cracked into light oil, but that will provide enough heavy oil for the lubricant. And we could speed this up. I want 3, not 2. Those take 3. Well, that will help. Let's make this 1,000. So, you see that get all pumped away. You can see our belts go into town now. And we have almost 1,000 lubricant now. And these guys are going. But our light oil is 0 now. Look, we're under 20. And these guys should kick in now. And then they'll turn off. But hey, we're now producing. Why'd you stop? Oh, you're pumping out. This is the pipe I want to be connected to. Not this pipe. That's a problem. Because this is the pipe that's pumping for the cracking. No, not there. You should go there. We need you there. There. So now this won't get backed up, and you won't stop nearly as often. Because you can see this pipe is empty. Yes, now you're empty. You're basically empty. You can run all the time. We'll get some more beacons in here at some point to speed you up another 50% or so. Meanwhile, we're running down to the end of this episode. And, hey, look at that. We're all done over here. Let's head back over there. No, we're not all done. Where was I? Where was I looking? I was probably looking at that one. You see, we got our copper, and our coal, and water, and oil, and look at that, we've already even launched a rocket? Two rockets. Is the train still over here waiting? Or is reloading? It should be almost there. What are we missing? Probably beacons. And hey, wait, it's on its way. I think it has an 180 beacon, so we'll need a bit more. Who's missing a track and a signal? Or a change signal, I should say. There's somewhere else missing 13 signals. Normal signals. Yeah, so you can see we have this science factory, and hey, we supplied it just from around here. So we can definitely, you know, maybe fit one in here. That's not too much oil. And, you know, so if we cover it, it's not a big deal. And get, you know, we got room for more. So I might take a little bit of a break after 1.0. But I'm guessing we can hit 2,000 science per minute. Not 2 science per minute. Let's actually pull you up a bit. So you're not blocking the other tracks here. Let's finish off this build here by turning that on. Alright. Oh, you're just lights. I don't care about the lights. I mean, you guys, it doesn't matter. Uh, is. Don't need to be there, that's just from when I replaced the blueprint. Looks like we got the beacons, modules arriving. Where's the down to 30? Alright, they're no more on the train. They'll be placed momentarily and then filled with the right modules. So we're pretty close here. Not quite done, but it'll be done real soon. So, didn't go the way I wanted. Let's start a research. And, I mean, this is as good as any. It's probably the most expensive one we have right now. 256? Yeah. Well, let's hit this. Kind of wanted it for when this was gonna launch. But things didn't go the way I had planned. Just in a minute here, we'll check. Production is a little down, but that may be just because it's backed up the most. And yeah, this doesn't use purple. There we go. It's over 1,000 now. But yeah, there we go. We have 1,000 science per minute, at least over 1 minute. There was our 750. I mean, the real test is if we can keep this up for at least an hour. But I'm sure you don't want to wait around for that. Alright, let's cut this out here. So, I'll definitely be doing an episode, hopefully for my normal Saturday release, when 1.0 comes out, and we can check up on how this did. How are we doing? Well, it's most of the 10 minutes it's not been running, but you can see, yeah, we're at even 1.1. Where's the... We're missing one, aren't we? And there's probably been no rocket launch in the last minute. Yeah, this is still waiting. There's still 16 here, 4. And now it should launch. Oh, it says launched already. Look at that. Yeah, that's right. We not just when this is empty, when it passes here. Yeah, there we go. And yeah, we're still actually missing a few beacons. You see small gaps in production a little bit, but apparently not enough to affect this, or at least... Even though I call this a 250 science per minute, it's probably 260, and the other ones make up for the lack of production here. So yeah, this is our factory. Pretty big. But yeah, we got room to expand. You know, definitely maybe a science factory here, and get some outposts. And then here and or here, we definitely can get a few more. You can see our frame rate is actually starting to dip a little bit. Maybe that's just on map view. Yeah, that's just on map view when viewing everything. Still want to expand the solar a little bit here, and then, you know, maybe starts filling in solar here or somewhere else like that. And then we can turn off one of these, or maybe two of these nuclear power plants. Talking about power, I mean, since we're kind of reviewing stuff here, we're using 14 gigawatts, so yeah. We can definitely turn off at least two of those nuclear power plants. We could produce 37 right now. Each of those power plants are about 4, so actually we could turn off more than that. We're doing about 3 with our solar, but that's not a true 3. You got some percentage of that is going to charge. So, you know, maybe when we completely fill this out, where is the, the URA corner? Yeah, maybe when we completely fill this edge here would be, you know, almost 3. Gonna fit right in there nicely. Now I'll leave that for when this gets. Well, maybe just put it in now. Oh, now it's at 2. Yeah. With all those, maybe then we'd be at 3. So with that launch, I'm going to say thanks for watching. Hope you stay safe, wash your hands, and I'll see you next time, hopefully with the release of 1.0 of Factorio. I'll see you then.